We have got 10 exciting days planned. You know, every year is an exciting opportunity to explore the best of Kamloops as well as the best of film. So we're going to kick off with the opening night. We've got a little VIP function for our sponsors, and then we walk the red carpet. You got to walk the red carpet. Don't miss out on that opportunity to take a stroll and have your photo taken. And generally, we have a Q&A at Hotel 540 at Blue. After the Q&A, we've got some fabulous entertainment. So this year, we've got our opening night gala. We're taking over Blue, as well as the entire hotel lobby at Hotel 540. We've got Kathy Marshall, Chris Rustin, and band. And it's going to be a groovy, jazzy little evening. They're keeping the kitchen open, so if our nibbles are not enough to satisfy your appetite, we'll have a whole meal for you. It's going to be great. Now, definitely check in with the website, with social media, and we're going to have lots more information about that as it comes up, but we often do special events that are attached to the movie. So we're going to do a brewing discussion at Red Collar Brewing Company, which is awesome. You get an opportunity to sample some different beers and try some of their fabulous nibbles. We also do the wining discussion, which we're doing at Blue. And again, we're connecting with the Kamloops Wine Trail with this initiative. So you can come and enjoy a lovely glass of wine and have a sweet little chocolatey treat after the film, as well as the steeping discussion at PDK. So you can enjoy a hot drink, a coffee, a tea with a donut. And they've always got little nibbles there. And again, we have casual conversation about the film. It's nothing led, it's not a seminar, but it just gives you an opportunity to connect with other people in the community about the film that you've just seen, about the other films you plan on seeing, and about the film festival and the community in general. Every year, I try to catch as many movies as possible. Last year, I saw 17 out of 20 films, and they're all very interesting and emotional and fantastic, but I do tend to lean towards something a little bit lighter, about the sort of poetry of day-to-day life.
Morning, Donnie. Everything okay?
No, not really. My kid needs braces on her teeth. My car needs a transmission job. My wife wants me to take her to Florida, but I'm behind on the mortgage payments. My uncle called from India and he needs money for my niece's wedding, and I got this strange rash on my back. How about you?
I'm okay.
Patterson, starring Adam Driver, which is a Jim Jarmusch film. It's about a bus driver who's also a poet, and he's sort of just about all the people that he connects with in his day-to-day life, and I'm really looking forward to that one. Another hot movie, which I'm going to recommend sort of checking your IMDb parents guide for, it is Elle, which is a French film about a woman who is viciously attacked in her home and decides to not involve the police but take revenge. And she was nominated for an Oscar, and she actually won the Golden Globe. And the movie also won a Best Foreign Film at the Golden Globe. So that one's going to be really interesting. There's also a family-friendly feature called Oddball and the Penguins, which is going to be a ton of fun. It's an Australian film. It's based on a true story, and it is about an island that was inhabited by penguins, and foxes got on the island. And basically, they put a dog on there to protect the penguins, and it's going to be a really feel-good, quirky comedy. So there's definitely something for everybody.
Stop.
Thinking that you know everything that's going on.
No, I don't. I just think that, you know, having your heart broken is a tremendous way to learn about the world.
I'm really excited about the closing night film. 20th Century Women is going to be a spectacular movie. It's got Annette Bening and Greta Gerwig and Elle Fanning, and it's a coming-of-age movie in 1979. That's going to be a nice way to close off the film. It's going to be keeping it light, in a way, leading into the closing night party. We've got a sweet DJ coming on this year, and so we're really hoping that people come and they stay for the closing night and just, like, dance the night away. So I've been in the Film Festival for 4 years. I've been involved with events as well as marketing, and I love it. It's a lot of work, it is a lot of work, but I love movies and I love being a part of the collective that brings these movies to Kamloops. Every year I write an article that goes in the Kamloops Film Festa insert that goes in the newspaper, and it's really fun to explore my reasons for being involved in the Film Festival year after year. And what originally started as it being this Kamloops staycation and enjoying the best of Kamloops and getting out and enjoying these films, I've come to understand that there's a deeper importance of having this event in our community. The story I'm working on this year is about narrative empathy, which basically is about why film and stories and arts matter as far as us understanding other cultures, other humans, other families, which I think at this time in this political climate, it's essential that we have that understanding that even though we're different, we're exactly the same, and the stories help connect us. So the Kamloops Film Festival is March 2nd to the 11th. You do not want to miss out. And actually also students get a fabulous deal. They get $5 per ticket. You simply can't beat it. Please do participate in one or several movies and do participate in all of the events. It's a really fabulous opportunity to connect with international and Canadian films. You don't want to miss it.